Hi, this is Peter Stanley. Welcome to my channel. Today I just want to do a quick video showing a comparison between the oldest and the newest models of the AeroGarden Sprout. I just got this one. It's the newest model, but it's the Walmart exclusive version, which is why it's all gray. And I got it for $20. The Walmart's doing a big clearance now. And if you've watched my last video, you can see how to locate these in your area, if they are any available. But there are a lot of design changes. The oldest one is a lot kind of clunkier now compared. It's got a base, the power cord's wired to the base. It has a built-in air pump that blows air through here. And that connects to a stem. Can't really see it. I've got water in here, so I can't really show it very easily. But there's a stem with a hole in it. The air comes up from the bottom and blows out, and that oxygenates the water. So I'm going to put this on here. Also, the old one is made to use CFL. And it's the AeroGarden CFL. Uses a G23 socket. So that, and the new one, totally different design. The base and light is all one piece like this, but it's a lot sleeker. The power connects externally to here, and then the power for the pump connects there. So it's got a little difference there. The lights are LED built in. And this one's full of water too, but it has a built-in, actually it's a It's a removable submersible pump, small pump, and then it comes up to the stem and kind of rains down in three little streams. So totally different how it operates. And I'll plug these in and show you how they look. So you can already tell, you probably hear this one's a lot louder. See the bubbles coming up. Now this is actually like the original model Sprout, but originally the stem had three tiny holes and get clogged up really bad. And then they came out with a replacement stem that had a slightly bigger, like a single hole, and that works better, but it still clogs up. So occasionally you have to take it out and clean it. And I think later the first LED version of this had like a much bigger hole in the stem. They've totally gotten rid of the whole setup since then. But let's plug this one up, and I'll unplug the white one of this old one. That's a lot quieter, and the water's not all the way up, so it's a little louder than it'd normally be. Another thing too, with the old one, it yellows over time. You can see, and I asked AeroGarden about support about it. They said it just happens with these, so I'm hoping the newer ones don't do that. One thing I noticed too, it's all the way down. The distance, this is like 4.5 inches. This is like a little over right at 6 inches. So the lowest height setting is, water on that, is a little higher for the new one. And I think the reason is because the light's more intense compared to the CFL. Another little side note on the old one, you can use a G23 adapter like that, and then like a screw-in LED, and then put that in here, take the CFL out, plug this in, and it works great. I did some tests, some par tests with it, and I'll do some quick ones here just between these two, but this one pulls around 23 watts, this pulls around 12. It puts out way more light, PPFD, than the CFL. Now I tested with this one, and it this pulls around 9 watts, and it puts out more light than the CFL, not quite as much as the AeroGarden LED. Something to consider, but these work great. I actually have two in my old AeroGarden 6 at work, and the light on the LED, on this Relassi LED, is a little warmer than these. It has a lot more red in it, but it should be fine for growing. So I just want to point that out. Got the Apogee Instruments MQ-500 sensor to measure PAR readings. And at the very very lowest setting on the CFL, the back port is getting 276, 515 on the middle one, and 376 on the forward one. The new one, the back port's 293, the middle is 395, and the forward's 287. And just remember, this is almost a couple inches higher. So if you put it at the same height as the, so you compare it the same. So this is 6 inches. If I raise this up a little bit, 6 inches. And we go back the old one. The back port's getting 210, 212, 309, and 257. Back to the LED. Same height, 279, 392, 290. So you can see, like, when they're set at the same height, this is putting out a lot more light. Yeah, this one's really loud. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's the aerator puts out a lot of, I mean, it's not really loud, but it's enough to, it's not as soothing as the, as this one is. So yeah, the controls are a little different. The, where you add water looks a little different. I can't show it now with these having water in them, but, yeah, but I've used this one a lot. They also have seat starting decks for these. So instead of three, you could start like 15 at a time. I actually have one going, and I'm going to start this one. I'll probably put the LED in it just to save electricity and put the seat starting deck on this. It's actually across the room. I can grab it, show it to you. And I've got another Sprout with a new seat starting deck. And those are actually a little different too. They're spread out a little more on the newer ones. And I'll show you how high these go up. I think the distance on the raised height is about the same, 10 inches from the bottom of the lamp to the deck, 9.5 inches. So it is a little different. It's 9.5 on the new one. But this one actually goes down lower and raises up higher. And it sits higher too because the base is a lot thicker. So that throws it off. So yeah, I'm a big fan of the Sprout. I like how they aerate. I really like, it seems like they grow better. Like roots have always looked healthier growing in this and some other systems. And this is the first time using one of the newer ones. So we'll see how it does. I think it runs perpetually. Some of the AeroGardens, like the Harvest models, will run intermittently. And those are the kind where the pump recirculates over the pods. And those run intermittently, which I don't really like. I kind of rather them just run all the time. But I think this runs all the time, and I knew this runs all the time. So kind of rambling a little bit. This is kind of a quick video. I just want to throw it together. Before I start, I'm actually getting ready to set these up, so it'd be harder to show with stuff in them. So I just want to get this shot before I do that. So anyway, yeah, check my video I just made on trying to locate these Walmart AeroGardens, heavily discounted prices. I'll put a link in the description, and also I'll put a link to the G23 adapters and LEDs if you want to do an LED conversion on one of these older models. These older models work great. You can tell there's a lot of changes they made between these two. So anyway, wrap this up. I just wanted to share this with you before I get these started. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you like that. Please like, comment, and subscribe.